Nabi is celebrated in the memory of the Prophet Hazrat Muhammad, peace be upon him. The day is for rejoice and for mourning, as this is the birth and death anniversary respectively. In other words, he was born, and at the same time, passed away on 12th of the same month. He was born on the 12th day of Rabee-ul-Awwal in Mecca in 570 CE. It is the third month of the Islamic lunar calendar. On this day, hymns are sung in praise of the Prophet, and it is also commonly believed that listening to those will make one receive worldly and heavenly rewards. However, the day is marked differently by the Shia and Sunni. The Shia community believes that on this day the Prophet had chosen Hazrat Ali as his successor. On the other hand, the Sunni community prays throughout the day. Several countries celebrate the day by taking out large processions in the street and by decorating their homes. Prayers are recited and sweets are distributed among the destitute. Various stories of the Prophet are also narrated. It is considered an important day for Muslims all across the globe, because it reminds one of the kindness, compassion and the teachings of the Holy Prophet. His devotees observe his birthday and show their reverence and love towards him. The tradition of celebrating the Holy Prophet's birthday on a large scale began in Egypt by the Prophet's descendants. Through his daughter Fatima, it was celebrated mainly by religious scholars and religious establishments. They gathered to hear sermons, distributed sweets, alms and particularly honey, the Prophet's favorite. Eid-e-Milad is also called Maulid, since it is Prophet Muhammad's Eid and the song sung in praise of the Prophet's birth is called a Maulid. From the Middle Ages, it was believed that listening to the recitation of Maulid has not only worldly but heavenly rewards too. This festival is also referred to as Barah Wifat, which stands for the 12 days of sickness of the Prophet. Before he passed away, the day is for both mourning and celebrating. The Sunni sect and the Shia sect have a different take on the ways of celebrating of this day. Shia Muslims celebrate this day to remember that Prophet Muhammad chose Hazrat Ali as his successor at Ghadir-e-Qom. This occasion symbolizes the hibil of the chain of Imamat or the next leader. Eid-e-Milad and Eid al-Ghadir are two names for marking the same day, for two different reasons. This name is used to mark the Prophet's birth and death anniversary. Eid al-Ghadir is used to mark the handing over of the spiritual reign to Hazrat Ali at Ghadir-e-Qom. The route between Syria and Yemen, on this day, believers gather to recite special prayers for thanksgiving to Allah for his favors in sending Prophet Muhammad to the world with his message to guide the people. People attend lectures and recitations on the life and instructions of the Holy Prophet. Poetry or naats are recited after prayers and sweets are distributed amongst the poor. Shia Muslims also mourn on this day, as it is also the day when the Holy Prophet passed away. Bora Muslims, a part of the Shia sect, too celebrate the 12 days in this month with prayers and by listening to recitals. Prayers are conducted in mosques for all 12 days. Many Boras perform ziyarat, a form of prayer that is performed as a meeting with the one you are praying to. Prayers are held throughout the month. On the 12th day of the month, Muslims remember the Holy Prophet and his teachings. Mourning on this day is not practiced at all, as many Sunni Muslims believe that mourning for the dead beyond 3 days hurts the departed soul. In India, people carry out processions chanting praises of the Holy Prophet and Imam Hazrat Ali. These processions are decorated with fruits, flowers or even scenes depicting religious sites, episodes and figures. The sweet dish, kheer, sweet porridge made of rice, is prepared as a tradition in Muslim homes. Whereas in Saudi Arabia prayers are held, sweets are prepared and the Prophet is remembered through his words. This ceremony, performed in some parts of India, is nothing but a procession. The Prophet's symbolic representation is placed in a glass casket and carried out as a procession. The symbolic footprints of the Holy Prophet engraved in stone, a representation of the barak and the horse, which are believed to have ascended to the heaven with the Prophet, are kept near the footprints and anointed with sandal paste. The glass casket is elaborately decorated. Marsias and elegies are sung while the procession is carrying on. This ceremony is the Urs or sandal. The religion of Islam celebrates three different Eids: Eid al-Fitr, Ramzan Eid, Eid al-Zuha, Bakri Eid, and Eid-e-Milad, Prophet Muhammad's birthday. All these stand for different occasions. Muharram is the Islamic New Year. It is not a time for merrymaking and celebration, but a time to remember the sacrifices of the holy ones. The history of this celebration goes back to the early days of Islam when some of their Tabian began to hold sessions in which poetry and songs composed to honor Muhammad were recited and sung to the crowds. The Ottomans declared it an official holiday in 1588, known as Mevlid Kandil. The term Maulid is also used in some parts of the world, such as Egypt, as a generic term for the birthday celebrations of other historical religious figures such as Sufi saints. Maulid is recognized as a national holiday in most of the Muslim-majority countries of the world except Saudi Arabia and Qatar, which are officially Wahhabi, Salafi. The date of Muhammad's birth is a matter of contention since the exact date is unknown and is not definitively recorded in the Islamic traditions. The issue of the correct date of the Maulid is recorded by Ibn Khalakan as constituting the first proven disagreement concerning the celebration. Among the most recognizable dates, Sunni Muslims believe the date to have been on the 12th of Rabi'ul-Awwal, whereas Shia Muslims believe the date to have been on the 17th. Since the Islamic calendar came into existence after Muhammad migrated from Mecca to Yathrib, now Medina, the date of death is known, but the date of birth is not known. In early days of Islam, observation of Muhammad's birth as a holy day was usually arranged privately and later was an increased number of visitors to the Maulid house that was open for the whole day specifically for this celebration. This celebration was introduced into the city Sabta by Abu Labaz al-Azafi as a way of strengthening the Muslim community and to counteract Christian festivals. The early celebrations included elements of Sufic influence, with animal sacrifices and torchlight processions along with public sermons and a feast. The celebrations occurred during the day, in contrast to modern-day observances, with the ruler playing a key role in the ceremonies. Emphasis was given to the Ahl al-Bayt with presentation of sermons and recitations of the Quran, sources, Wikipedia and websites. Thanks for watching.